The combo of steel lead screw and a brass nut is the choice for most printers on the market today. But it's literally metal-metal rubbing action that requires even lubrication to reduce wear and ensure smooth movement. So why not just use materials that have way lower friction coefficients, like Teflon, also known as PTFE, or Delrin, that also known as POM. Friction between those two feels almost non-existent. That is why I got quite excited when I saw a combo of Teflon coated lead screw and a POM nut at a reasonable price. Not only should it provide smoother movement, but also won't need any lubrication, it is simple set and forget type of modification. But is it too good to be true? Well, I made before and after test prints, built a jig that provided actual data, and checked the movement of the Z-axis with a dial indicator to determine the truth. So let's find out more after this very quick sponsored segment. If you have unique ideas that require professional PCB manufacturing, CNC machining or similar services, check out PCBWay. The ordering process is such a breeze as every option is well visualized or explained, and if you need more information, multiple articles will get you up to speed. So make sure to check them out and also get 5 bucks off for your first purchase via the link in the video description. So first we should ask ourselves, do we need the benefits that an upgrade like this could bring in the first place? And the answer in general to that is, well, yes, we always want the smoother movement, as that reduces the friction and in some scenarios where the lead screw is not perfectly aligned could potentially lead to more consistent movement. But we should keep our expectations realistic, as in my previous Z-axis related video where I even upgraded the 3D printer with a ball screw, we only saw very tiny improvements despite modification offering extremely smooth and spot-on Z-axis movement. Then what about the maintenance-free aspect? Well, this is what I think would be the biggest benefit, as you don't need to worry about the uneven lubrication or your cats constantly trying to sabotage lead screw movement with all the stuck hair. For the prints, I will use filaments from 3 different manufacturers that they kindly sent for these tests to be as diverse as realistically possible. Before printing, I kept them in a dry box just to make sure the moisture won't be a factor here. With prints done on a regular lead screw that was freshly lubricated, we can check out the Teflon coated one. And what I saw through a microscope made me concerned. The finish looked quite poor with some chip outs of a coating. It is day and night compared to even a used steel lead screw. Plus, you won't be able to spot this with a naked eye, it just looked flawless out of the box. But the most stupid thing about it was that the nut seemed to have threads for irregular size screws. So you either have to buy a POM nut that has M3 threads or use longer screws and secure them with nuts. But this installation process made me appreciate the no lubrication aspect instantly. As if you work on the Z-axis, there is almost no chance you're getting away without accidentally touching the greasy lead screw. So with new parts installed, I reprinted the same G-code files. And before the first comparison, please keep in mind that I tried to expose the irregularities with the worst lighting conditions, because anyone can show you how perfect the prints look with the right lighting angle. So first, my design test cube using Geo's Meta PLA filament, and right away both prints look basically identical. There was no clear indication of improvement or decline in print quality. Looking at them in regular lighting conditions would be just a guessing game. Next, the famous Benchy with Filalabs PLA filament. And just like before, despite how much he tried to look at the prints, I couldn't find anything that would set them apart, even in these extremely unfavorable lighting conditions. Then I checked the spider print using any cubic PLA filament. Here I would say the model with Teflon coated lead screw maybe looked tiny bit better, but again extremely small difference. And for the fourth print, the lizard model with the same brand but different color filament. But again, no difference whatsoever. So yeah, even with not a good surface finish, it seems that the print quality wasn't impacted negatively. But that got me thinking, what about the possibility of the coating just peeling off quickly? To somewhat test that, I wrote the most basic G-code that moved the gantry 10 mm up and down 10,000 times in total. It took 8 hours and there was some dust looking material, most likely the POM nut, as the wheels, which are made from the same material, also experienced the wear, just way more by the looks of it. To confirm that, I cleaned the lead screw and tried to find the spot, but I couldn't, it looked like new. So, how much less friction is with this setup? To make a relative comparison, I assembled a simple test jig. By slowly raising the voltage and checking how much milliamps the motor consumes, I can calculate how much power it needs to lift the weights from multiple heights on the lead screw. The metal lead screw with POM nut required around 20% less power to lift the weights than the standard combo of a metal lead screw and a brass nut. Meanwhile, the Teflon coated one helped reduce that by around 34%, meaning that coating is not a lie and it provides less friction. So far, it looks like a great upgrade, right? Well, this is where things took off the cliff after checking the movement fade dial indicator. The metal lead screw and a POM nut combo had consistent enough movement no matter at what height they tested. Teflon coated lead screw seemed to be accurate, but there were spots where precision was impacted by uneven coating. And that trend continued no matter at what height I tested. But the second Teflon coated lead screw that I had was even worse. The movement was all over the place in some spots. So using a better one, I printed this cylinder in a vase mode and honestly it didn't look too bad, considering the lighting angles. But when compared to the regular metal lead screw and a POM nut, we could actually see the more consistent layers. This leads to a quite simple conclusion. The Teflon coated lead screw is not a scam. It has significantly lower friction than a regular combo of a metal one plus a brass nut. But smoother action doesn't mean anything if the coating leads to inaccurate movement of a Z-axis. So inexpensive Teflon coated lead screws are kind of pointless gimmick that only seems to be great until you test it. However, consistent coating would make this a great option, but that means the price increase and at that point a ball screw could also be considered as an option. However, despite this unsatisfying ending, we learned that even without any lubrication we can use a POM nut to reduce the friction between two parts. This would be a great upgrade for dual Z-axis as the load of a gantry splits in half on the nut, increasing its longevity. And for single Z-axis, I'm not sure. I will keep using it as it only brings benefit of smoother movement and no need for lubrication. The only question is longevity. They are quite affordable, so changing it once in a while I don't think would be a problem. So what do you think about all this? Will you try a POM nut instead a brass nut on your 3D printer, or maybe you already have one installed? Do you think it is worth it? Well, I hope you found this interesting and informative. If you did, please don't forget to like the video. By doing this, you not only support my work, but also help the video to reach more people. And I'm all about providing the most in-depth results that are based on actual testing data. If you want to be part of the people that contributes to making these testing videos even better, consider becoming a patron. Thanks to everyone who supported or still supports the channel. Well, that's all from me, and we'll see you next time.